गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन। दिस इज अवर प्रैक्टिस सेशन नंबर वन। आई एक्सपेक्ट यू बिफोर वॉचिंग दिस सेशन, यू मे वॉच माई सेशन ऑन एल्जेब्रिक आइडेंटिटीज इन विच आई हैव टेकन द डिफरेंट वेराइटीज ऑफ प्रॉब्लम एज वेल एज ए बेसिस टू द दिस कंसेप्ट। माई सेल्फ दिनेश मिगलानी, दीज सेशन आर वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर SSC प्री एंड मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन एज वेल एज फॉर बैंकिंग एग्जामिनेशन। You may connect me on my Facebook @DineshMiglani. My WhatsApp number is 0921551435. Email ID legalbuddy@gmail.com. You may subscribe my YouTube channel @DineshMiglani on YouTube so that you will be acquainted with my new videos, because on that regular information is there on uploading of new videos. I expect from you share these videos on your Facebook wall as well as with your friends so that more and more people will be benefited by this. Let us start with the first question of this session. It is given that 4p divided by p square minus 4p plus 4 equal to 1 by 4. We have to find the value of p square plus 16 by p square. First step, I can cross multiply. That gives me 16p equal to p square minus 4p plus 4. That you can say, right? Now what I can say in the next step, because I need the value of p square plus 16 by p square, that means if I divide both sides by p, so I get it as 16 equal to p minus 4 plus 4 by p, or else I can say p plus 4 by p equal to 20. That you can say, right? Now I need p square plus 16 by p square. Now it is very easy for me to make the square, just squaring both sides. You may get it as p square plus 16 by p square plus 2 into p into 4 by p equal to 400. P is cancelled out, so I can say p square plus 16 by p square equal to 392. So my answer is said to be 392, hence I can say second is my answer, 392, that becomes my answer. Okay, now what you have to observe, that whatever you have to find p square plus, plus 16 by p square, that can only be found when you take it as p plus 4 by p. Okay, so we have to make it as p plus 4 by p, then we can find that. Let us have the next question here. What is given to you? That 4x minus 2 by 3x is equal to 4. I have to find the value of this, right? Now I know that we have to make a cube, because here 3x I can make, that is 27x cube. Here I need 2, so I just cancel out 2 here. So what I will get, 2x minus 1 by 3x equal to 2. Now cubing both sides, a minus b cube, a cube, that is 8x cube minus b cube 1 by 27x cube minus 3 into a into b 1 by 3x into a minus b, so that is equal to 2. Just make it as 2 and it is equal to 8, right? Now what I can say, 8x cube minus 1 by 27x cube, x would be cancelled out, 3 would be cancelled out, so I can say minus 4 equal to 8. So finally I can say 12 is my answer. Okay, hence I can say third is my answer. Here I can say answer is said to be 12. Right? Let us have the next question. It is given that x raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4 is equal to 47. I have to find the value of x plus 1 by x. Okay? Now what I can say here, that because I know x plus 1 by x, it means I have to decrease my powers. Let us just start with it. X raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4 equal to 47. I add 2 here, 2 here, that's 49, and that would be square of x square plus 1 by x square whole square. So from here I can say x square plus 1 by x square become equal to 7. Here I cannot plus minus 7. Why? Because this is even, but the power is even and power is even, both are positive, hence I can say that is 7. Now I need x plus 1 by 7. I add 2 here, add 2 here. Here I can say x plus 1 by x whole square equal to 9, or x plus 1 by x would be taken as plus minus 3, right? Hence I can say answer is said to be third one, plus minus 3. Here I can make it plus minus. Why? I know that because here power is 2, x can be positive or x can be negative, right? If I put it x plus 1 by x equal to 3, in that case my value would be 9. If I put it equal to minus 3, in case I get my value to be 9, right? So hence I can say third is my answer. Let us have the next question here. Just try to read the question. X square plus y square equal to 5. x y equal to 1, right? I have to find the value of x raised to power 4 minus 2x square y square plus y raised to power 4, right? Now when I look at this, right, so what I can say, I can simply say that, although this could be easily answered how, just make the square of that, x square plus y square whole square, this would be 25. From here I can say x square plus x raised to power 4 y raised to power 4 plus 2x square y square, that is equal to 25, right? I know x y is equal to 1, it must be 2, hence I can say x raised to power 4 plus y raised to power 4 is equal to 23. Now I have to just put my values in the answer. This is 23, this is 1, so minus 2, 23 minus 2, 21, hence I can say answer is said to be 21, right? Now in this question, it is very easy for us to, why? Because x y is given to us, right? If x y is given, so I can easily find the value of x raised to power 4 plus y raised to power 4, right? And now I can solve it. My answer is said to be 21. Let us have the next question here. Now in these type of questions, you have to solve it. It is equal to 5 plus root 7. We have to find our value, right? Now what I can say, one states you that just take the help of the option, put here 4, 16 minus 9, 7. 16 plus 9, 25, that is 5, 5 plus root 7, hence I can say first is my answer. Now in your examination, the better choice is always use the help of the options, because options are always the better choice. Where you have to find the value of x, and where x is given into small integers, it's better to use the options, right? So here if I put x equal to 4, I am getting my answer, hence I can say first becomes my answer. Let us have the next question here. It is given that x equal to 1 by 2 plus root 3. Immediately I can go for rationalization, right? So this gives me 2 minus root 3. So I can say x equal to 2 minus root 3, right? And there y is equal to 1 by 2 minus root 3, right? So what I can say, if I go for the rationalization, so I can say that is equal to 2 plus root 3. Okay, now I have to answer it. My question here is 1 by x plus 1 plus 1 by y plus 1. Okay, now in this question, if I just go for it by put my value x is equal to 2 minus root 3, so I can say 1 by 2 minus root 3, so that would be 3 minus root 3. Similarly, in place of y, so what I can say that y is said to be 2 plus root 3, so that is 1 by 3 plus root 3. Now take the LCM, in denominator a plus b into a minus b, 9 minus 3 is 6, it should be 3 plus root 3 plus 3 minus root 3. This is cancelled out, 6 by 6 1, hence I can say third is my answer is said to be 1. Now in these varieties of question, it is expected from you immediately go for rationalization, because that helps you in order to simplify your problem. Let us have the next question here, a similar type problem. A is given and B is given to us. We have to find out the value of 1 by A plus 1 and 1 by B plus 1. When I say 1 upon A plus 1 plus 1 upon B plus 1, put A equal to root 2 plus 1, you get to be root 2 plus 2. Similarly, B is equal to root 2 minus 1, make it as plus 1. This is cancelled out, right? So what I can say, just take my LCM, I can say root 2 into me, 2 plus root 2. Numerator should be root 2 plus 2 plus root 2. Okay. The next step I can go for rationalization. Right. So that gives me 2 minus root 2 divided by 2 minus root 2. Okay. Now just simplify it. In denominator I get root 2. 4 minus 2, this is 2. Right. Here, what I can say, root 2 would be cancelled out because it is 2 root 2. Right. Or I can say root 2 would be cancelled out. So that becomes here root 2 plus 2, right? It is 2 minus root 2. It is cancelled out from numerator because here it is 2 root 2 plus 2. So I have taken root 2 as common, right? Now, when I look at it, 4 minus 2, 2, answer is said to be 1. Hence, I can say third is my answer. Okay, now simplification question. Only you know how to rationalize, then you can easily answer it. Let us have the next question here. It is given that x equal to 2 minus 2 raised to power 1 by 3 plus 2 raised to power 2 by 3. Now, it's a very specific question. Whenever you have anywhere power 1 by 3 and 2 by 3, take this term here, make it as x minus 2. Make it as 2 raised to power 2 by 3 minus 2 raised to power 1 by 3, cubing both sides. So what do you get? X cube minus 8 minus 6x into x minus 2. It should be a minus b cube, a cube, that is make it cube, 2 raised to power 2 minus b cube, that is 2 minus 3 into a into b into a minus b, right? A minus b, that one we can make it as x minus 2 here, right? Now here I can say x cube minus 8 minus 6x square plus 12x equal to 4 minus 2, 2, this is 2, 3 minus 2, 6 into x minus 2, right? So from here what I can observe now, I can say that x cube minus 6x square, 6 minus 6 plus, that is said to be 18x, okay? And here I can say minus 8, this is plus 12. I can say minus 8 minus 2, that is minus 10 and plus 12 equal to 0. X cube minus 6x square plus 18x equal to minus 2. Now this is minus 2 plus 18. X cube minus 6x square plus 18x. Let us have just a look at, just make the cube. A cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. So what do you get? X cube minus 8 minus 6x square plus 12x, right? Cube it, a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. Here I can say a cube, 4 minus 2, 2, right? It should be minus 3 into 2, 6, x minus 2, right? So what I can say here, that we have just taken that plus 6x minus 6x plus 12x is minus 8, minus 2 minus 10, and this is plus 12, and it goes here, right? So I can say minus 10, it's minus 10, and when I take this value, minus 12, sorry, that we have committed a mistake, it's minus, right? So here I can say that is plus 22 here. Now what I have to find, I have to take here 18, add here 18, the answer is said to be 40. The whole question we have taken it rightly, some basic mistake we have committed here, so that's why we are not getting it, our answer is said to be 40. Next question is, now it's a very simple statement. Two things you note down. One thing is, if at any place in mathematics you have x plus 1 by x equal to 2, this is only possible when x is equal to 1. And if you have x plus 1 by x equal to minus 2, this is only possible when x is equal to minus 1. Okay? Now, from here I can observe x equal to 1, it should be 1 plus 1, 2, third is my answer. Okay, no need to any problem, just wherever you have this type of expression, that is only possible when x is equal to 1, hence I can say final answer is said to be 2. Let us have the next question. It is given that x raised to power 4, 1 by x raised to power 4 is equal to 119, right? We have to find out x cube minus 1 by x cube. Now that could be found when you have x minus 1 by x. So first we have to go for x minus 1 by x. Add 2 here, add 2 here. So this becomes x square plus 1 by x square ka whole square. This is 121. So from here I can say x square plus 1 by x square equal to 11. Right? Now I need x minus 1 by x. I subtract 2 here, subtract 2 here. So here I can say x minus 1 by x equal to 3. Okay? Now what I need x cube minus 1 by x cube, cubing both sides. This is x cube minus 1 by x cube minus 3x into 1 by x into x minus 1 by x. So 3 cube is said to be 27. Now x cube minus 1 by x cube, x is cancelled out, minus 3 into 3 equal to 27. This is minus 9 plus 27, 36. Hence I can say 4th is my answer. Answer is said to be 36. Now, idea is very simple. You can do all the thing in mind. How? Plus 2 plus 2. It means x square plus 1 by x square equal to 11. Then minus 2 minus 2. X minus 1 by x is equal to 3. I have to make the cube of it, just cube it and solve it. You can finally say your answer is said to be 27. Okay, answer here is 36, right? Hence I can say fourth is my answer. Let us have the next question here. It is given that x minus y equal to x plus y by 7 equal to x by y by 4, right? That is given to us. We have to find what is the value of x into y, right? Now, what I can say, I can just take first two pairs, x minus y equal to x plus y by 7, cross multiply, 7x minus 7y is equal to x plus y. This gives me 6y equal to 8y, right? X equal to 8 by 6, we can say 4 by 3y. That we can say, right? Now, with that, I can just find the value for y. By putting, now we have x equal to 4 by 3y, right? Now, what I can say, put this value either in this or this and put it equal to xy by 4. When I put x equal to 4 by 3y, so I can get y by 3 equal to x equal to, you have 4 by 3, y into y by 4. That you have. 4 is cancelled out, 3 is cancelled out. Y is cancelled out, so hence I can say y is equal to 4. When you have y equal to 4, so I can say x equal to 16 by 3. Y equal to 4, x equal to 16 by 3, right? I have to find x, y. Just have a look at what we have done. We have compared these two. X minus y, x equal to 4 by 3 y, 4 by 3 minus y, that is y by 3. X equal to 4 by 3y into y by 4. 4 is cancelled out. Y is cancelled out. Right. And from here, what we can say? Y is equal to 4. Just have a look. 7x minus 7y is that one. It comes here. 6x is equal to 8y. X equal to 8 by 6y, or we can say 4 by 3y. Right. Now, second step, we have put x equal to 4 by 3y here. So what I can say? 4 by 3y minus y. That is 4 by 3 minus y. So that is said to be y upon 3 is same as to xy by 4. X is equal to 4 by 3y. X in place of x, we can say 4 by 3y into y by 4. Right. Now I have to solve it. 3 is cancelled out. 4 is cancelled out. Y is cancelled out. Right. So from here I can say y is equal to 1. That we have committed a mistake. We have taken y to be 4. That's wrong. Y is equal to 1. If y is equal to 1, so I can say x equal to 4 by 3. Hence x into y is 4 by 3. First is my answer. Although we are doing it rightly, sometime because when you solve number of problems, so there is some mistake in your mind. Here we have committed a mistake, right? So that we have to take care of. Let us have the next question here. Now it's a general question for using of the formula. How? We have to find ABC and AQ plus BQ plus CQ is given. We know the formula. AQ plus BQ plus CQ. Minus 3abc, this is always equal to a plus b plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca plus 3abc, right? Now, what we have, aq plus bq plus c cube is 36, that you have, a plus b plus c you have, this you have, right? We have to only find this value. For that, what I can say, just take a plus b plus c whole square. This is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus twice of ab plus bc plus ca. Right? Now a plus b plus c is 6. 6 square is 36. That is 14 plus twice of ab plus bc plus ca. 36 minus 14, 22 by 2, 11. Right? I can say ab plus bc plus ca is equal to 11. Okay? Now just put all the values here. What you have, this is equal to 36 minus 3abc equal to a plus b plus c 6, a square plus b square plus c square is 14 minus 11, right? 14 minus 11 is 3, 3 into 6, 18. This goes there, this comes here. So I can say 18 equal to 3abc, right? Or else I can say abc is equal to 6. That becomes my answer. Okay, now this particular question is somewhere use of this formula and this formula. If you know this formula, and here we know that all values we have, we don't only have AB, BC and CE, that could be found by this formula, and finally I can say 6 is my answer. Let us have the next question here. It is given that AQ minus BQ is 56, A minus B is equal to 2. I have to find the value of A square plus B square, right? Just take A minus B equal to 2, cubing both sides, AQ minus BQ minus 3AB into A minus B, 2 cube is 8, right? This is 56, so 56 minus 3AB into 2 equal to 8, right? Here I can say, this comes here, 56 minus 8, I can say 48 equal to 6AB. Here I can say AB is equal to 8. That you have. Now, the next thing is we have to find A square plus B square. Square this. So you get it as A square plus B square minus 2AB equal to 4. Now, this is 8. 2 into 8, 16. Goes there 20. Hence, I can say A square plus B square equal to 20. That becomes my answer. Okay, hence I can say answer is said to be second one, A square plus B square is equal to 20. Let us have the next question here. There is similar type problem. What is given to us? X plus Y plus Z equal to 9. X square plus Y square plus Z square equal to 35. So first we try to find out X, Y, Y, Z and Z, X. So let us say square of X plus Y plus Z 81 equal to X square plus Y square plus Z square plus twice of XY plus YZ plus ZX. Okay, now this is equal to 35, comes here 81 minus 35, right? That is said to be 46 by 2. Hence, I can say XY plus YZ plus ZX is equal to 23. That you have. Now, I have to find the value of XQ plus YQ plus ZQ minus 3XYZ. Okay, now you know the formula. What is the formula? X plus Y plus Z, that you have 9, into X square plus Y square plus Z square 35 minus XYZ 23. Okay, that is the formula. 35 minus 23, that is 12. 12 into 9, 108. Hence, I can say answer is said to be second one. Answer is 108. Let us have the next question here. It is given that A square equal to B plus C, B square equal to A plus C and C square equal to A plus B. I have to find this value. I have to find the value thrice of A plus 1. Okay. And this is 1 by B plus 1 plus 1 by C plus 1. That value we have to find out. Now, how to answer it? So from statement I can say A square equal to A plus A square equal to B plus C. I may say A equal to B plus C by A. Because I need A plus 1. If I make it as A plus 1, this would be taken as B plus C by A plus 1. Or I can say A plus 1 is B plus C plus A by A. That you can say. Right? Or else I can say 1 upon A plus 1 equal to A by A plus B plus C. That is there, right? Now just put it, 1 by A plus 1 is A by A plus B plus C, 1 by B plus 1 is B by B plus C, A plus, ठीक है? So what I can say, LCM would be A plus B plus C, it should be 3 into my numerator would be A plus B plus C divided by A plus B plus C. This is cancelled out, hence I can say 3 is my answer. Here answer to my question is third, 3. Next question is, it is given that X equal to 27, we have to find Y. Now it's a very simple question. Just put here 27, cube root of 27 is 3 and cube root of 729 is 9. So 9 minus 3, this is 6. So I can say Y raised to the power 1 by 3 is equal to 6, cubing both sides 216. Hence I can say third is my answer. The minimum value of this expression, this is X square plus 1 by X square plus 1 minus 3. That you have. Right, put X equal to 0. 0, when I put here 0, that is 1. 1 minus 3 minus 2. And taking the value to be minus 2 here. Now, my first and second option would be eliminated. Right. Now, the next thing I can say, this cannot be 0. Hence, my minimum value is minus 2. Hence, I can say 4th is my answer. Here, in this question, the minimum value would be minus 2. Where it is minus 2? Where X is equal to 0. Let us have the next question here. A plus b is 5, a square plus b square is 13. I have to find a minus b square, right? So what I know that a minus b whole square is always equal to, first, with that first we have to find for a b also. First we have to go for a b also. So let us just take the value of a b first. Take a plus b square, 25 equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Put here 13. So here I can say AB is equal to 6. Right. Now I need A minus B. Make the square of A minus B. This is A square plus B square minus 2AB. Minus 12. I am getting to be 1. Hence I can say A minus B is equal to 1. Answer would be positive. Why? Because he has mentioned in the question that A is more than B. Hence I can say first is my answer. It is given that a plus 1 by a plus 2 equal to 0. So in this I can say a plus 1 by a is equal to minus 2. It means a equal to minus 1, right? Now if I put a equal to minus 1, so minus 1 raised to power 37, that is minus 1 minus 1. Final answer is minus 2. Hence I can say second is my answer. My answer is minus 2. Next question is x plus 1 by 16x equal to 1. I have to find the value of 64x cube bar plus 1 by 64x cube. Now this would only be found out when we have 4x plus 1 by 4x cube, right? If I multiply these both term, both sides by 4, so I get it as 4x plus 1 by 4x equal to 4. If I multiply both sides by 4, this is 4x plus 4, that is 1 by 4x equal to 1. Now cubing both sides. 64x cube plus 1 by 64x cube plus a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b equal to 4 cube is 64, right? This is cancelled out, hence I can say this is equal to 12. 64 minus 12, answer is said to be 52. 52 becomes my answer, hence I can say second is my answer, 52, right? Let us have the next question. For two real consonants a and b, the expression ax cube plus 3x square minus 8x plus b is exactly divisible by x plus 2 and x minus 2, right? Now in this, if it is divisible by x plus 2, we have to apply the factor theorem here. If it is divisible by x plus 2, hence I can say f of minus 2 must be 0. Put in place of x minus 2, right? So this would be minus 8a plus 12 plus 16 plus b equal to 0. My first equation is minus 8a plus b equal to minus 28. That's my first equation. Let us have the second equation, x minus 2. Put here x equal to 2, f of 2. So this is equal to 8a plus 12 minus 16 plus b equal to 0. So here I can say 8a plus b equal to 4. Second equation. Now check out the options here. 2 and 12, that's not my answer. 2 and minus 12, 16 minus 12, 4, I am getting it, 2 and minus 12, put here 2, that is minus 16 and minus 12, minus 28, hence I can say third is my answer, A is 2 and B is equal to minus 12. Let us have the next question here. It is given that x square minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0, we have to find x cube plus 1 by x cube, right? Now it's a very simple thing. Sometimes we commit a mistake in these type of questions because we don't know how to solve it. For answering that, I need x plus 1 by x. Divide by x, you get x minus 3 plus 1 by x equal to 0. Now it's a very simple question. You get x plus 1 by x equal to 3. Cubing both sides, a cube plus b cube plus 3 into a into b into a plus b 3 equal to 27. Right, what I can say, 3 into 3, 9, 18 is my answer. So I can say that x cube plus 1 by x cube is equal to 18. Second becomes my answer. I hope you enjoyed the session. So this is end to our first practice session of algebraic identities. Now these sessions are very helpful for algebra, because if you are going for the CAT or other management entrance examination, for that you require algebra. All these are the basis for that. If you don't know how to solve the equations, if you don't know how to use that formulas, how you can solve the bigger problems, as well as these are very specific questions that are being generally asked in the SSC pre and mains examinations. I hope you enjoyed the things. Thank you very much.